Hello friends, welcome to the Viva House of Anatomy. Today we will discuss about the radiology of a upper limb. But before that, we will see how to read the radiological film. Now there are four different types of the film given to you in the exam. The one is of a X-ray, film of the X-ray. The second is of a ultrasonography, USG. Third is of a MRI. And you may given the fourth, the CT scan. After the identification of the film, these four different type of the film, the second thing you have to identify is the type of the film. Now, it may be either of a plain type or a special type of a film. Here you can see on the right side of this board, this is a plain type of a X-ray and this is a special type of the X-ray. The difference in these two type is, in the special type of the X-ray or a film, there is a use of a radio opaque dye. This radio opaque dye will outline the different structure or the organs, and we can easily see its outlines and or any anatomical abnormality. Whereas in the plain type of the film, there is no such dye will be used. These two X-ray are a plain type of a X-ray. The third thing you have to identify is the view of the given plane. Now there are different type of the view are available. The first is the anteroposterior view, then the posterior anterior view, third lateral view, oblique view, and some special views. In the anteroposterior view, the rays will coming from the anterior side and it will focus on the radiological plate which is placed on the posterior side. So you can see the proper structure which is close to the plate. Second, in the posterior anterior view, the rays are coming from the posterior side and it will focus on the radiological plate which is given on the anterior side. Here in this X-ray, this is the AP view of a shoulder region. Here the rays will coming from the front and it will fall back on the radiological plate. And in this X-ray of the thorax, the reverse posterior anterior view is taken. Then the third, the lateral view, in which the rays are coming from the lateral side and focus on the plate which is placed on the medial side of a region. Then the oblique view, in which the region is placed obliquely. So you can better to see the structure which is placed side by side. Another view is a special type of view in which either the special position is given or we are the radiation is. And the last one is a special view in which the special position is given to the patient and then the X-ray is taken. It is to visualize the special structure. For example, the paranasal sinus in case of the skull. To see the paranasal sinus, we are taking the Waters view. Same way to see the patella clearly, we are taking the skyline view. Next thing you have to identify is the side of the X-ray, whether it is of the right side or the left side, or in the bone X-ray, which is the right and the left side. It is clearly understood by a linear right, R for right, and if it is a left, then given the later M. Here this is the right shoulder and here in the thorax this is right side and opposite obviously will become the left. The next thing you have to identify the region of the X-ray. For example, it is a shoulder region. This is a thorax, abdominal cavity, pelvis, knee joint, ankle joint, head and neck, etc. After that, in the X-ray, you have to identify which are the structures seen. The structures which are seen in the X-ray are the bony tissue, the joint, some soft tissue, some fatty tissue, some air sac or some liquid sac. Now, this different structure will impart the different colors. For example, the gas and the air. In the lungs, you will have a gas. This gas shadow will appear as a dark structure. You can see the air in the lungs here and here. The second, the film. the fatty tissue will appear as a dark gray in color. Here you can see the fatty tissue, the dark gray, the fat. It is a fresh shadow in which the fat is present. Here in the arm also there is a fat. The soft tissue is somewhat lighter gray in the color. After that, the fluid will appear as a hazy, and the bone and the calcification will appear as a white structure. The bony part or a calcification, like the stone in the ureter or the calcification in any gland, can appear as a white structure. And last, some metal. Sometimes the patient may have wear some metal structure that will appear as a brilliant white in color. Here in this X-ray, this locket appears as a brilliant white. It is whiter than the shadow of the bone. So this is all about how to read the radiological film. Now we will see the X-ray of the upper limb. The first X-ray, the shoulder region. Now how to read this X-ray? So this is, first you have to describe the type. In the upper limb and the lower limb, mostly we are taking a plane type. So this is a plane type. Second, you have to describe the view. It is an antero-posterior view, AP view. Third, the region. It is of a shoulder region. And fourth, of a side, the right side. So it is a plane type, AP view of a right shoulder region. Now you have to describe the which are the bones you can able to identify. So here, the bones of the upper limb which are seen are the clavicle, the scapula, and the upper end of the humerus. Apart from the bone of the upper limb, you can also able to see the ribs, upper ribs, and the vertebrae. Right? Now we will see the different part of the bones. The first, in the clavicle is having two ends, the lateral end, this one, and the medial end, this one. Lateral end will articulate with the acromion process of the scapula to form acromioclavicular joint, which is a plane variety of syncopal joint. The medial end will articulate with the sternum to form the sternoclavicular joint, and it is a saddle variety of syncopal joint. In the scapula, we can see that three angle, superior angle, inferior angle, and lateral angle, which form the glenoid cavity. Three border, superior border, medial border, and lateral border. And having three processes, the acromion process, coracoid process, and the spine of the scapula. Now the glenoid cavity, lateral angle, will articulate with the head of the humerus to form the glenohumeral joint or a shoulder joint, which is a ball and socket type of a synovial joint. Now the second X-ray of upper limb, that is of a elbow joint. So first we will read this X-ray. This is a plane type AP view, anteroposterior view of a elbow joint, and it is of a left side. Now which are the balls you can see? The lower end of the humerus, upper end of the ulna, and upper and upper radius. Now in the humerus, you can able to see, this is a medial epicondyle, this is a lateral epicondyle. The large fossa here, impression of the large fossa seen is of a polyclonal fossa. This is ulna, this is the radius in which clearly we can see the head of radius, nape, and radial tuberosity. The second view is a lateral view of a same elbow joint. Here you can see the balls lie side by side. It is overlapping with each other, radius and ulna. And the side view of the humerus you can see. The same thing you can see in this X-ray, the elbow joint. Additionally, in the ulna, you can able to see the polyclinal process, coronoid process, and dystrochlear nodes. This is about elbow joint. Now the third joint. Now the third X-ray of the upper limb is the X-ray of the hand or a wrist joint. How will you read this? It is a plain variety anteroposterior view of a left side a wrist joint or a palm. And this x-ray is a plain type oblique view of a wrist joint, again left side. Now which are the bones you can see in this x-ray? First in the AP view, the lower end of the ulna and lower end of a radius. Second bones, you can able to see this group of the small bones, they are the carpal bones. In the proximal row, there are the four carpal bones from the lateral to medial. The thumb side will be the lateral side. The first bone is a scaphoid, then the lunate, tricuspid, and the PC bone. Now these two bone lines overlapping with each other anteroposteriorly. So here you can see the overshadow of the PC bone over the tricuspid. In the distal row, same, the trapezium and the trapezoid. Third, capitate and hamate. And here you can see clearly the hoof cap of the hamate also. Now the distal to the carpal bone, there are the five metacarpal bone. They are numbered from the lateral to medial side. So this one, the shortest one is the first metacarpal, second, third, fourth and fifth. Now remember, in the head of the first metacarpal, you can see the rounded calcification. This is an unnamed sesamoid bone which is formed in the tendon of a flexor pollicis longus muscle. Distal to the metacarpal bone, you will have a proximal phalanges. And distal to the proximal phalanges, in case of the thumb, there is a distal phalanges. And in the remaining digit, there is a middle phalanges. Distal to the middle phalanx, there is a last distal phalanges. Now, the joint which are seen in the whole x-ray are, starting from the proximal, we will go distal. The first joint, inferior radioantral joint, which is a saddle, pivot variety of a synovial joint. The second is a wrist joint between the lower end of the radius, scaphoid and the lunate. The wrist joint is an ellipsoid variety of synovial joint. Then the intercarpal joint, which is a plane variety of synovial joint. Now the joint between the carpal and the metacarpal bone is known as the carpometacarpal joint. There are the five carpometacarpal joint. Out of this, the first one, the first carpometacarpal joint, is having the separate joint cavity and it is a saddle variety of synovial joint. And the remaining carpometacarpal joint are a plane variety of synovial joint. Then the joint between the metacarpal and the proximal phalanx is a metacarpophalangeal joint and it is a condylar variety of synovial joint. And the last joint between the phalanges is an interphalangeal joint and it is a hinge variety of synovial joint. So this is all about the radiology of our